Hey guys, this is Robbie's Reviews. In this video, I'm going to do a rating and review for the Canada Goose Langford Parka. Alright, so as you guys know, I rate and review each of my items based on four categories. Those categories are features, functionality, quality, and comfort. I'm going to start with the features on the jacket. So I've updated a lot of new Canada Goose coats to my website. I update it about once a week, and they sell out pretty fast this time of year. So be sure to check out my website if you're interested in purchasing Canada Goose coat. It's in the link in the description box below. All right, I'm going to describe the features on the Langford Parka and then get into describing some of the things I've liked and disliked maybe about the features on this jacket. So you've got these high hand-worn pockets up here. They're fleece lined. You've got these lower Velcro enclosed drop-down pockets. They are pretty deep, but they're not that wide. We got the heavy-duty ribbed cuffs like most Canada Goose coats on this jacket. You got the patch on the left-hand side. For the hood of the jacket, you can put the hood up, and you have the tunnel hood on this jacket, so you can zip it up all the way like this and really enclose your entire face and head in there. The fur is removable on this coat as well. You got a zipper right here in which you can remove the fur on the jacket. So you have two heavy-duty raglan K zippers on the front here, and you have Velcro enclosure over that, kind of a storm guard. You've got a wind guard underneath the zipper here, and inside the jacket you have a Napoleon pocket. It's a small to medium size with zipper enclosure on it, and you have one drop down pocket here. You also have these pull strings here that you can pull the kind of the hip in and give yourself a little bit more of a tapered look if you'd like. That's the bulk of the features on the Canada Goose Langford Parka. Some things I've liked about the features on this jacket in particular, I really like the high hand worn pockets. So those, whenever I see those on Canada Goose jackets, I just think it's a big plus because it is. These things are comfortable. They've got fleece lining in them, so you're going to keep your hands nice and warm in there. So one feature I'm not a huge fan of is the Velcro enclosure on the overlaying the zipper here, just because a lot of stuff tends to get stuck in the Velcro here and doesn't look as good. As well as I don't really like the sound and having to just, you know, open and close it all the time. And it does tend to get weaker as it ages. So I would prefer like snaps or something else, but that's one downside of the features on the jacket. Otherwise though, the jacket has a lot of nice, great features on it. I like the tunnel hood on the jacket. It does a great job keeping your head and your face warm. I like the hand warmer pockets. So overall, the features on this jacket, it's an 8 out of 10. All right, so next up is functionality. Now my functionality ratings essentially ask the question, how well does an item do what it's supposed to do? And this item, of course, is a winter parka, so it's supposed to keep you warm. So in my time wearing this Langford jacket or wearing Langford jackets for like the last 2 years, I found they do a really good job of keeping you warm. Especially, they do a really good job of keeping you warm kind of from your waist below. Obviously, it's a longer coat and it's supposed to keep you warm there. So these Langfords don't have a whole lot of downfill in them. They're not too puffy, as you can kind of tell from the silhouette of the jacket. And that's a good feature for most part. I was a little hesitant when I first got the Langford because I wasn't sure if it was going to hold up in some really extreme conditions. And for the most part, this thing does hold up really well. It does a good job of keeping your core warm, keeping your arms warm. I do notice that the shoulders tend to get a little cold. I'm not exactly sure why that is. It might just be because the kind of the pressure or the way that jacket fits on me puts a little pressure on the down fill in here and kind of collapses the down pockets. Don't get too overheated in the jacket either, so that's a good feature, being that there's not too much down in it. You know, if you compare this to like the Resolute jacket, which has a lot of really thick down quilted sections in it, this jacket doesn't have quite as much of that. I can maybe show you on the inside of the jacket. So if you can see kind of here, it's these squares, they're not too overfilled with puffiness. In terms of other things like wind, the jacket does a good job of protecting you from the wind. Essentially, any Canada Goose jacket that has this kind of exterior, which is in almost all their coats, will do a good job of keeping you warm in the wind and keeping you dry, except, you know, in like serious rainfall or snowfall. So overall, this jacket performed very well in the cold conditions. It does exactly what it's supposed to do, and it does it pretty well. So it gets an 8.5 out of 10 when it comes to functionality. All right, so next up is quality. So this jacket is a pretty high quality jacket. It's gonna be in line with other Canada Goose jackets, of course. I do notice a few things from wearing these jackets or seeing these jackets that have been worn for a few years, is that the rib cuffing does tend to split a little bit. So with some heavy wear, you might notice that some of these seams in here, so you can get the camera to zoom in on it, will rip a little bit, and that's not a huge issue because a tailor can fix that in like for like $10. I did notice that though. I do notice on the cuff, they tend to get a lot of wear, as I noted in other videos, and some fading here and some splitting if you're not careful. Otherwise though, the other issue with the quality on this jacket is that the arm down tends to get a little flat. So you'll want to try to prevent, you know, putting too much wear on the arms or rubbing your arms against things. I know it might be a little hard to do and be conscientious of that. But that's one thing to note about the arms. You notice your arms get a little cold when the down gets a little flatter, so be kind of mindful of that. So overall, this jacket is going to last you a long time, though. It's a high-quality jacket with high-quality components. I give this jacket an 8 out of 10 when it comes to quality. All right, so last up is comfort. Now, this jacket is a pretty comfortable jacket, like other Canada Goose parkas. It's going to be very lightweight. I notice these types of jackets are lighter weight than like a Woolrich Arctic parka I've worn, or a Moose Knuckles Sterling parka, I believe it's called. So that's a really big plus for me. I don't like to be bogged down. I don't like to wear heavy, kind of like a heavy-duty, heavy jacket. I just like to wear something comfortable when I'm walking around the city or I'm driving my car. So one thing with longer parkas, just in general, they're a little less comfortable with your legs, so they're a little restricting in your legs. You can zip the jacket up like this, which is a pretty nice feature, actually, to give your legs a little bit more mobility. This is kind of a personal preference. I just like jackets a little higher up, a little more like a waist length, because they just feel more comfortable when I'm sitting down. So you will feel a little bit more like you're wearing a longer jacket, and you will be reminded of that a little bit more often as opposed to a shorter jacket. So I'm going to give this jacket a 7 out of 10 when it comes to comfort. So here's my overall rating for the Canada Goose Langford Parka.